Welcome back, everybody. A diagnosis of cancer is enough to deal with. Another concern for some patients is the possibility of not being able to have children after chemo. There are now better options for women who have been diagnosed with cancer and even women who have waited longer to have children. Here to tell us more about this exciting new breakthrough, please welcome from the Advanced Fertility Center of Texas, Dr. Stephan Krotz.
When it comes to cancer, a lot of people, obviously, the first thing in their mind is the fight for their life.
Right.
But a lot of us really aren't well-versed on just the impact that chemo and other treatments can have on the body.
Correct.
And one of them has to do with fertility.
Right. So a lot of the treatments that they use to treat cancer, such as chemotherapy and radiation, can actually hurt the woman's reproductive organs and make it much more difficult for them to have children in the future. And this can happen in up to 70% of women that are being treated for cancer.
Yeah.
So
before you would work with that with conventional methods, but now you can plan for that, if you will.
Right. So one of the great things that's been developed is an area called fertility preservation. And what fertility preservation aims to do is to help women who've been diagnosed with cancer avoid the harm that can come from those treatments so that they can have a pregnancy and have a family in the future. And this is important because women are increasingly surviving cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And after they beat the diagnosis, they want to go on to have a family and have as much of a normal life as they can.
Yeah, there's a friend of mine, 25, was diagnosed with cancer, and she thought, there's nothing I can do about it. Well, they had planned for it, and now she has children. Okay, so the way that we can do this is that you take the eggs before they start the treatment?
Right, so it's actually can be quite a challenging period because women may be diagnosed with cancer, they have a lot of questions, but this is really a great opportunity to shed light on the subject, and that anyone who's been diagnosed with cancer, please, and that's in that reproductive age, to please see your doctor or your fertility specialist before you go through the treatments, because in a matter of 2 to 3 weeks, we can help you save your eggs, and then at a later date when you've beat the diagnosis, then you can come back and start a family.
Yeah.
Now, in the past, actually, egg freezing did not meet with very high success rates. But now, because of improvements in technology, it's gotten much better, and now it's comparable with in vitro fertilization.
Wow. Okay. So freezing that egg, and what about freezing an actual embryo? Can we do that, too?
So there are multiple ways that you can preserve your fertility in the face of a diagnosis of cancer. And so for patients that already have a partner, they may want to consider undergoing in vitro fertilization, and then they can freeze their embryos because embryos have the best chance of giving you a baby after you're treated for cancer. But one of the newer technologies is now freezing eggs, and as we mentioned, the pregnancy rates have gotten much higher.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's great for patients that aren't even of the age where they're thinking about a partner, a lot of patients who are dealing with pediatric cancers, or patients who have not found that special person yet and later on know that they want to have a family.
Yeah, which is a big discussion that a lot of women, especially, you know, we have our careers and things like that, or you just haven't found that right person, that you're approaching 40 and you're thinking, okay, well, should I not be able to have a child just because I haven't found that right partner in time?
Right.
So you have women that will come in and say, okay, let's get these eggs aside and then we'll see if it comes to be in the future. At what age are those eggs starting not to be as good as they could be?
So that's a great question, and this is something that we discuss with patients every day in our practice. So at the age of 35, you start to see a decrease in fertility that's significant. And this is important because a lot of patients may be holding off, waiting for the perfect time, but honestly, there's never really a perfect time to get pregnant or have a baby. And as your fertility declines at age 35, if you do get pregnant, the miscarriage rate also goes up significantly. And that's mainly because beyond the age of 35, there are problems with the eggs, with the chromosomes, that make it harder to get pregnant. And then if you do get pregnant, it makes it harder to stay pregnant.
Yeah. And then the other thing that's kind of interesting is that we, as long as you have those good eggs, women can carry almost forever,
right?
If it's donor eggs or your eggs that were frozen and then implanted. So to beat the clock, that's the way to do it.
Right. And so freezing eggs is also one option now for patients that haven't found the perfect partner, and especially if they're able to do it before the age of 35. then later on they can carry a pregnancy well into their 40s.
All right. To learn more about new options for fertility preservation, you can call the Advanced Fertility Center of Texas at 713-467-4488. 713-467-4488. You can also log on to infertilityanswers.com. And as a special incentive, the first 50 callers today will receive a free consultation when they mention they saw Dr. Krotz on Great Day Houston. That's a $225 value, so if you can benefit from their services, this is a great offer. We'll be right back.